It has been 6 months since the encounter between the USS Sandy and the massive Sabari colonist ship that arrived at Mars. In response, the United Nations decided to create a new Earth Space Force to protect humanity from the aliens. Because of our role in encountering the Sabari last year, we have been offered positions in the new Earth Space Force. I will be given the rank of commander, you and Carrie will be lieutenant commanders, and Richard, Diana, and Janet will be lieutenants.
But we've never served in any military before.
It's not that much different from when I served in the town's police force and had to go to Austin to defend that city from a militia of extremists known as the Faithful Remnant.
Also, members of the U.S. Space Force will be installing weapons on our ship, including a couple of laser cannons.
So we are really going to war.
We have to be prepared. Who knows how many other Sabari ships may be out there? I know the Sabari commander said he wouldn't attack us, but I don't trust him.
A few weeks later, a small spaceship appears above Earth and its arrival causes a panic around the world.
After the spaceship enters the Earth's atmosphere, it sends a message.
Greetings, humans. I am Jormik of the Nikos race. Unlike the Sabari, who are your enemies, we come in peace. We wish to make contact with the human known as James Smith Bentley. He is the spokesperson for your people, yes?
After receiving this message, the US President contacts James.
I have directed these new aliens to the town in Texas you live at. Find out for us what they want.
Will do, Madam President.
James then puts on his new Earth Space Force uniform and goes to meet the alien leader, Jormik, outside the town.
Why are you here? And why did you want to meet with me? We need your help. Commander Otto of the Sabari told you he was part of a space empire and that his people are 10,000 strong. Those were lies. In truth, there are only 2,000 Sabari, all on Mars, and the other 8,000 are us Nikos. And we are slaves of the Sabari. Slaves? Why would a highly advanced race bother with slavery? Thousands of years ago, we Nikos and the Sabari shared the world we both evolved on. But because the Sabari had more advanced technology, they conquered us and forced us to serve them after killing off millions of us as a warning. We would spend our days working on farmlands growing food for the Sabari, making them rich while we remained in poverty. Eventually, the economic corruption of the Sabari ruined our home world. The environment became so polluted that in desperation, the Sabari decided to leave our home world even as billions of us were dying out, leaving the 10,000 survivors you know about. You humans are making some of the same mistakes the Sabari did, but at least you do not have slavery. If you help free my people, we will be your loyal allies afterwards. I can't speak for my people, but I will certainly bring your story to my leaders. You should act quickly. By now the Sabari know of my escaping to make contact with you and they may be inflicting punishments on my people as a result.
James then tells the US President what he has learned.
I want to take part in a task force going over to Mars to attack the Sabari and free the Nikos from slavery.
More than a dozen spaceships have already been built to defend Earth from a possible alien invasion, but we may need more to go on the offensive. Congress has already declared war on the Sabari, so our resources and manpower will be put to maximum effort to defeat them. Mars and all the other planets in the solar system belong to us humans, so we must punish them for intruding on our space.
Do you trust these Nikos? I remember when we Americans were manipulated into going into a totally needless war against Iraq in 2003. We were told that Iraq had weapons of mass destruction and that its dictator, Saddam Hussein, was prepared to use them against his neighbors. Several Iraqi defectors made statements under oath testifying to the existence of those weapons. But after we conquered Iraq, we learned that those claims were total lies. Saddam Hussein had already dismantled his weapons programs because his country couldn't afford them. And because we wasted so much of our resources occupying Iraq, we neglected Afghanistan, enabling the Taliban, a real threat to America, to take back control of that country. We completely failed.
I agree that we screwed up with regards to both Iraq and Afghanistan, but Mars is a different matter. The settlement of the Sabari on that planet is not acceptable and they must be punished for their intruding into our solar system. I can't wait to get out there and bust their asses.
On Earth, a fleet of ships is prepared to go to Mars to do battle against the Sabari. They will be led by Admiral Omar.
Admiral, your mission is to defeat and conquer the Sabari, free the Nikos from slavery, and establish a permanent presence of humans on Mars. Before you go, consult with James Smith Bentley, commander of the USS Sandy. He first encountered both the Sabari and the Nikos, so he should be most helpful.
Yes, Madam President. I will contact him. Are you prepared to launch your own ship to join with us?
Indeed, I am. Just say the word and we will be on our way.
Then I hope you don't mind if I use your own ship as the flagship for our fleet.
Are you sure? My ship is not very large, and it can only hold a dozen people.
That doesn't matter. I have chosen it because it was the first to reach Mars. You and the others will benefit from having an experienced commander in charge.
As you wish. Penny, I'm going to leave you, Jen, and Mac behind. If we are going to war, there is no need for you and our children to be put in harm's way.
You know I'm going to be worried sick about you as long as you are out there, but I admire you for stepping up to fight for our people.
Best of luck to you, Papa.
Thank you, my son.
The next day, the Earth Space Force fleet is launched, along with the Nikos ship that reached Earth earlier. Together they proceed to Mars and arrive less than a week later. In their arrogance, the Sabari didn't anticipate the coming of the enemy fleet and thus were unprepared for the assault they would be facing. Sucks to be them, obviously.
We have arrived at Mars, Admiral.
Good. Now let's bust some alien butt. Admiral Omar to all Earth ships. Begin the attack on the enemy. Now. And in the end, even Commander Otto's flagship is attacked and destroyed by the Earth forces. No. This can't be.
Admiral.
as they used to say in the video game Mortal Kombat, Earth Space Force wins. Fatality.
With Mars now under the control of humans and their Nico's allies, the people of Earth can finally have their celebration over the arrival of James and the others of the USS Sandy in the previous year. Commander, now that the Sabari threat has been dealt with, I will stay on Mars to oversee the establishment of a human-run colony here. You and the others of the USS Sandy are hereby relieved of your Space Force duties and may return to your civilian lives on Earth.
Thank you!
It was an honor serving with you.
I can't wait to get out of this uniform. Being in the military never suited me, but I'm just glad I and Carrie could help punish those intruders.
Actually, Diana and I were wondering if we could remain on Mars and in the Space Force as scientists helping to explore the planet. We want to continue what we started several months ago.
Yes, you and your wife are certainly welcome to stay here. Thank you.
Carrie and I will miss you and Diana, but I know this is a great opportunity for you two to make some amazing discoveries. Good luck. I promise you both, I will take good care of your son. Goodbye, and give my parents our love.
And with that, Admiral Omar, Richard, and Diana are left behind on Mars while the USS Sandy returns to Earth.